We had an amazing season of strawberry production this year. I planted 20 strawberry plants last November, and I just couldn't believe how well they kept producing. Last fall, I grew the sequoia, which began producing in March, and with the benefit of early summer rains, continued well into June. Central Texas strawberries are best planted in the fall for spring production. When growing strawberries in warm climates, it's best to choose short day varieties. Strawberries don't tolerate our summers well, but cool season establishment and overwintering can be rewarding. What's up, everyone? It's Scott from New Garden Road. I'm here to inform, inspire, and elevate you. Encouraging biodiversity and restoring habitat is my mission. One garden at a time. Let's talk about some of the basic principles for growing strawberries. You want to choose a location with 6 to 8 hours of full sun, but in warmer climates, a little afternoon shade may help to extend the season. They need good drainage and a soil depth of 10 to 12 inches. That's why raised beds are an excellent choice. Ahead of each new season, I prepare the soil with compost and an organic granular fertilizer. They are heavy feeders, and along with a weekly application of Neptune's Harvest Fish Fertilizer, I'll side dress them with the Sustain brand 464 every few weeks throughout the growing season. While strawberries are self-pollinating, they will be aided by pollinators. The fruit will generally set and develop best between 70 and 75 degrees. Let's talk about the typical planting and growth cycle for strawberries. If you're planting dormant crowns in the fall, you can expect them to form new roots and leaves, and then flower and set fruit. And then those plants will stop flowering and form runners and daughter plants in that sequence. Soil and air temperatures will affect the timing and duration of these different phases. So I mentioned short day varieties, but what are some of the other types of strawberries that you can grow? There are long day varieties, which are often referred to as everbearing. Those will do great in more northerly climates, producing well throughout the summer. And then there are day neutral varieties. Those will flower and set fruit whenever the conditions are right throughout the season. Short day varieties, often referred to as June bearing or spring bearing, will grow best throughout the shorter days of winter. I just had the best season of strawberries yet. Planting strawberries on the border of my raised bed made for easy harvesting. Many times I would come out and I could visibly see those strawberries just hanging off the edge of the bed. Companion plantings of spinach and shallots were also really easy to work in. I planted the spinach directly from seed, and the variety that I grew was the giant winter spinach. That easily takes up 1 square foot of growing space, and I had 6 square feet in the middle of that bed. They took off and really filled out. Planting the shallots was an afterthought, but it was really easy to work them in there. They don't need a whole lot of space to grow, and I planted them close to the border in between the strawberries and the spinach plants. The plants that I picked up at the nursery were not in a dormant state like bare rootstock typically are. They set out runners not long after transplanting, and it seemed like I ended up with twice as many plants by the time spring arrived. The harvest sequence was at times overwhelming, but ultimately we were able to enjoy them fresh with very little preserving. In my previous growing season, I utilized 40% shade cloth. I thought this would help to double as bird netting as well as extending the season once temperatures got hot. But this year I chose to use bird netting. The plants definitely benefited from having more sunlight, and there was certainly better access for pollinators. And while snakes aren't an issue in my garden, it is worth mentioning that bird netting can be detrimental to snakes. They're part of biodiversity, and that's something that's central to my organic gardening practice. Can they take the heat? I don't expect the strawberry plants in my garden to survive the summer, and I intend to plant again each fall. They're growing in full sun, and most will begin to turn brown even when covered with shade cloth by about mid-June. And since they're taking up valuable planting space, I'll compost them when they begin to struggle. Kind of what I thought. Feeling the hype. Gonna flip it. Flip it around. All right, let's talk about it. Water break. You got this. You got this. Now check out more awesome gardening videos on my channel. Like this video and follow New Garden Road for weekly content. You can grow your own food. Keep it organic. Getting kind of noisy. Hey, night.